Chen moved slowly, signaling for everyone to stop. The cat looked up at him, a blank expression on its face. It meowed softly, as if asking what he wanted. "Hold position. Don't trust, little kitty cat." The cat walked towards the pool, its shadow growing over the water. It grew and grew. The reflection wasn't a common house cat at all, but some large, cat-like monstrosity. Its head had no ears or eyes, and its body was covered in small, mouth-like orifices. Klaus whispered from behind,
"MTF Kappa 14, prepare to drop the net."
Up above, the agents held the net at the ready. The cat looked up at the net, its body suddenly contorted, tripling in size.
"Now, drop it!"
The net came down, bundling the cat up. Chen walked over. The cat had returned to normal size. "Aw, cute kitty. Lock it up. Let's go." Welcome back. Today I bring you SCP-3718, an environmental catastrophe.
"Cat, you say? I don't know no cat, Doc."
"Listen, you're already on thin ice. After that last stint with your buddy Manny, you should be glad Fuller hasn't got his hands on you. You never know what he might do."
"That ain't that bad. Gives me a better meal than you guys do."
"Fine, have it your way. I'm sure that cat doesn't much like our food either. Chen, you think they'll like some little baby hors d'oeuvres?"
Baby back ribs.
Whoa, take it down a notch, fellas. I was just teasing. Sure, I know them cats. We call them mulers. I'm not sure where Fuller got them from, but he had a supplier. They were part of the menagerie of mayhem."
"But you called them mulers."
"Yeah, Herman Fuller's mind-bending mulin monstrosities don't quite roll off the tongue, you know? Anyway, they ain't so bad. Give them some attention, a little food, and they'd only scratch you like every third time or so."
"Sounds like my roommate's last cat."
"How'd that work for you?"
"Let's just say, Kitty won't be bothering Chen no more."
"Jeez, what did you do to it?"
"What? Nothing. Roommate moved out."
Continue on, please."
"Like I was saying before Janet over there piped up, you ignore any animal and it'll go feral. These things quicker than most. They ain't quite made for this world."
"Are you implying that they're extra-dimensional?"
"Yeah, that's the word. The dealer got them from the library or the bazaar. They're close, but not quite right."
"Anything else you can tell us?"
"That's about it. But I'll have my secretary set up another appointment if something comes to mind."
"Yeah, you do that." Chen came into Klaus's office. "We've got a problem. Reports coming in of disappearances of large animals in a national park. About 30 kilometers from the last Mueller spotting."
"Looks like there's more than we expected."
"I've got MTF Sideshow Bob on standby."
"All right, let's go. Any other info?"
"Just so happens we found some leftovers from Herman Fuller's Circus of the Disquieting, less than a kilometer from the sighting."
"That confirms it. Mueller's. Let's go."
"Agent, Doctor, how are we today?"
"Marissa, it's been a while since we've needed your services."
"I hope you haven't missed me too much."
"We've managed. We have an SCP, which appears as a normal cat, but has an interdimensional version, which is basically a monster, but only visible in reflective surfaces. What do you have for us?"
"Have you tried petting it and then checking if you still have a hand?"
"Don't make jokes. Chen would probably try that."
"I'd taste better. You're all bones, Doc."
"I might have something for you. One moment, please."
She flicked through her tablet, searching for something.
"Ah, this should do."
Behind her, in a set of drawers, she pulled out a helmet with a visor.
"Interdimensional spectrometer. Should allow you to see your cat beastie."
"Nice. These look like fun."
"That's a $200,000 piece of equipment there, Agent Chen. I expect it back in one piece."
"I make no promises," she sighed.
"Typical."
As they cleared the top of the hill, they could see the remnants of the circus below. It was a wide-open clearing. Herman Fuller had been here, not long ago. Down below, agents were scouring the area, looking for any signs of Mueller's.
Be careful with that helmet. It costs a fortune, and we only have one.
Yeah. The O5 can afford a new one. Everything's expendable.
That means you too.
Hadn't thought about it that way. Chen gently placed the helmet on his head. He looked through the tree line. So far, nothing. An agent stood on guard. Everything seemed quiet. Suddenly, the trees behind him started to shift and bend. There it was, coming through the trees behind the agents, an enormous, cat-like creature. Agent, move! Behind you! It was too late. The creature spat some sort of acid from the orifices in its body. The agent screamed as it started to burn and dissolve him. The creature snapped him up into its mouth. Chen took off at a run towards the beast. It glared back at him, preparing to flee. Chen leaped for the agent. As he flew through the air, something smashed into the side of him, sending him sprawling to the ground. Damn it! Marissa's gonna kill me! He looked up to see a small, black cat sitting beside him. It shifted and grew 3 times in size before his eyes. Oh, darn.
Net it!
The net came flying from around his side, snagging the cat as it shrunk down to normal. Nice shot, but there's still one free. It took off into the woods with the agent. They pushed through the trees. They found the agent lying face down on the ground. He was dead. Keep moving. We're looking for a cat. The agent searched the trees and surrounding areas. Up ahead in a clearing, they saw it. Pass me the gun. Chen took careful aim and fired the net. Bingo.
You're on your own. You break it, you bought it.
Aw, come on. She's gonna kill me.
Better you than me.
Doesn't catching the last Mueller count for anything?
I suppose it probably does. Let's get a closer look at the thing. I'm super curious to see it in detail.
Me too. Klaus hit the control panel as the mirror lowered down behind the cat. Oh, for crying out loud. SCP-3718 is an unidentified species of organism, outwardly resembling individuals belonging to the species Felis catus, the domestic cat. While SCP-3718 instances are visually identical to non-anomalous Felis catus, when viewing the reflection of an SCP-3718 instance, a large, tripedal organism can be seen in place of a reflection. These organisms are an average of 75 centimeters tall at the shoulder, exhibit numerous bioluminescent patches along the body, and are otherwise dark in coloration. These organisms possess no observable eyes or ears, but exhibit multiple orifices across the body, which are used in feeding. These organisms also possess highly sensitive vibrissae, which run the length of their body, allowing for instances to observe their surroundings by sensing changes in airflow. This organism cannot be directly interacted with, as it does not seem to occupy any space that it would take up around the Felis catus body. SCP-3718 instances are active predators. When feeding, SCP-3718 instances have been observed to cause a Class C3 spatial anomaly. During this, the Felis catus appearance will contort up to 3 times its normal size, and orifices corresponding to those on the appearance of its reflection will open and discharge pressurized digestive enzymes onto the kill. Once the digestive enzymes have had their effect, the orifices are used to grip parts of the prey and deliver it into the digestive system through rows of teeth. Due to their increased hunting activity, SCP-3718 has become a threat to natural wildlife, in some cases, drastically decreasing the populations of many species, including birds and deer. Currently, at least 3 species native to North America have been reclassified as critically endangered due to the presence and rapid growth of SCP-3718 populations. Because of this, SCP-3718 is currently considered an invasive species, and containment is considered a high priority due to the increased spread and risk of discovery. Any SCP-3718 instances discovered in the wild are to be sedated and brought in for containment, or neutralized if the current number of contained SCP-3718 instances is greater than 20. Foundation personnel are to monitor websites and animal control hotlines for mentions of potential SCP-3718 activity, as well as reports of individuals being attacked by cats or seeing monster cats. Any area that has seen a significant decline in local wildlife population in a small time frame is to be investigated for SCP-3718 activity. MTF Kappa 14, Sideshow Bob, has been instructed to examine areas where GOI-233 has appeared for stray SCP-3718 specimens. SCP-3718 instances in containment are to be kept in a large feline habitat at Site 23 and require at least 3 times the normal daily intake of food compared to a normal Felis catus. Personnel entering the enclosure are recommended to only do so when the SCP-3718 population has been recently fed or sedated. Researchers are currently formulating an artificially created virus that, when contracted by an SCP-3718 instance, would render it and any other instances that it comes into contact with infertile. Infected SCP-3718 would be released into the wild in spots with high concentrations of SCP-3718 activity. Proposal pending approval by the Ethics Committee.
Pets are a responsibility, especially the exotic ones. Don't ever just release them. You don't know what the ecological impact might be.
As always, have a care and remember to subscribe, like, and share. If you would. Until next time, farewell.